there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're solving simultaneous equations involving quadratics. So let's start with something you should already know. In the past, we've solved simultaneous equations by a technique called substitution. Look back in your linear equations, simultaneous equations by substitution, if that is not familiar to you, and work on that building block. Otherwise, pause the video and try this question. Okay, I would expect you, and you really have to know this before you do this video. The technique of substitution I introduced in linear equations, I said, is going to be really useful in more complicated cases. Let's go through what the technique was. Label equations 1 and 2. Because you had y equals 1 subtract 2x, you could substitute 1 subtract 2x into the second equation where you see y. And that would give you an equation with just x's in it. And I got from that x is negative 2. I substituted negative 2 back in to equation 1 and I got that y was positive 5. The solution was x is negative 2, y is positive 5. Please, 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 please go back to simultaneous equations by substitution in the linear equations topic if you don't know this, because you're going to need this for this video. And now I'm just going to go straight into two examples where I use this technique of substitution, but where I'm going to get a quadratic as well, something with x squared in it. Let's give it a go right from the start. Okay, solve y equals 2 subtract 3x and y equals x squared subtract x subtract 1. These are a pair of simultaneous equations. Let's start as we always do by labeling them 1 and 2. Now, because equation 1 is of the form y equals 2 subtract 3x, we can substitute in 2 subtract 3x for y where we see in equation 2. We can just put it here. Okay, so I can say substitute sub 1 in 2. So this here, I'm going to substitute it in place of y here. And what will I get? Well, I'll get 2 subtract 3x is going to equal x squared subtract x subtract 1. Now, I like writing my x squareds on the left-hand side, so if you don't mind, I'm just going to swap the position of these, and I'm going to say this is the same as x subtract 1 is equal to 2 subtract 3x. Now, I can only solve a quadratic when one side's equal to 0, so let me subtract 2 off both sides to undo that add 2, and let me add 3x to both sides to undo that subtract 3x. And let's tidy up and see what we get. What do we get? Well, I'm going to get x squared add 2x take away 3 equals 0. When I have a quadratic equaling 0, always try and factorize. This factorizes x add 3, x take away 1 is 0. Therefore, x add 3 is 0, or x subtract 1 is 0. If I subtract 3 from both sides, I get x is negative 3. If I add 1 to both sides, I get x is positive 1. Now, you're not done. To solve a simultaneous, you have to find the x and the y. This x is going to have its own y, and this different x is going to have its own y, which will be a different y. So we need to substitute negative 3 back into equation 1. So let's just write that here. Let's go over here and do that extra work and make sure you always show this. So sub x is negative 3 into 1, and what do we get? We're going to get that y is 2 subtract 3 multiplied by negative 3. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. 2 subtract negative 9 is like 2 add 9. Y would be 11. So that would be an answer here. And we could also sub x is 1 into equation 1. And we'd get y is 2 subtract 3 multiplied by 1, which is 2 subtract 3, which is negative 1. And y is negative 1 is an answer for this. So here is one pair of solutions, and here is another pair of solutions. And if you substituted them in to these equations, they indeed would work. Let's just give it a try. Let's put negative 3 in. 2 subtract 3 times negative 3, that's going to be 2 subtract negative 9, which is going to be 11, so it works there. Let's put in negative 3 here. Negative 3 all squared is 9. Take away negative 3 is like adding 3, so that's going to equal 12. Take away 1 is going to get you 11. This one works in both equations, and similarly, if you sub those in, this one would also work in both equations, and you know you're right. So there are a pair of solutions. Let's try one more. Pause the video and see if you could have a go at this one. It's slightly harder. Okay, as always, label them equations 1 and 2. Now the problem in this case is that neither equation is of the form x equals or y equals in order to solve. It's not as easy as that, okay? So I have to do a rearrangement of one of them to make them either in the form x equals something with y in it or y equals something with x in it, and I could do a substitution then. Now we've got absolutely loads of options, absolutely loads of options. From this one, we could add y to both sides and I would get x is equal to 4 add y. Okay, and if you think about it, I could make y the subject here. I could add y to both sides, as in this case, and then subtract 4. I could even make y the subject and make y equals x subtract 4. Either of those two I could use as a substitution into the second one. Okay, now it's probably easiest to substitute that into the second one, okay, because then we don't have to do any squaring of double brackets. So let's just say from 1, we know, if you know that, I'm going to show you where I got this just slowly, x subtract y is equal to 4, I could add y to both sides and I would get myself obviously that x is equal to y add 4, and then I could subtract the 4 off both sides and I get myself therefore that y is x subtract 4. Okay, and I could call that equation 3. Now I could sub 3 into 2. You must, because 3 came from 1, you can't sub it back into 1. 3 is basically a rearrangement of 1, so I've got to sub 3 into 2. And what would we get? Well, x squared stays as it is. Instead of this y, I'm going to write add x take away 4 equals 2. I can't solve a quadratic until one side is equal 0, so let me subtract 2 off both sides and tidy up. What will I get? I'll get myself x squared add x subtract 6 is 0. Try and factorize. This one does. X add 3, x take away 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, x add 3 is 0, or x subtract 2 is 0. Subtracting 3 off both sides, x would be negative 3. Adding 2 to both sides, x would be positive 2. This particular x will give you a particular y, and this particular x will give you another particular y. Sub them back in this one, it's easy to, or any of these, to be honest with you, this one would be a better one to sub them back into because it gives you y straight away. Y is x take away 4. Negative 3 take away another 4, that would be negative 7. And here y would be x take away 4, 2 take away 4 is negative 2. And you can check whether they work or not, but they will. Let's just try both of these in this. Negative 3 all squared is going to be 9. 9 add negative 7 is positive 2. Put this in here. 2 squared is 4. Take away 2 is 2. Both of these work. Happy days. There's one set of solution. There's another set of solution. And I'm done. And that's it for this particular skill involving solving simultaneous equations involving quadratics. Thanks loads for watching.